Get ready with me for bowling and dinner. Welcome one, welcome all, welcome back to another video. It's your girl Letty here, and I want to talk about life in my 40s, mainly exploring vaginal health, the topics we need to talk about, because there's been some changes, and I think anyone or any woman needs to know these things going into their 40s. So like, I've been 40 for almost 8 months, just shy of a few days, and I noticed as soon as I turned 40, my periods were like, hello. I was like, what is this? What is going on? Oh my gosh. Like, I started experiencing aches and pains that I've never felt before, and it literally started the day I turned 40, and I'm like, where was this at 39, 38? Like, why am I feeling this way right now? So it's like TikTok knows my thoughts. I don't even have to say them out loud. And then next thing you know, I'm seeing what I'm experiencing on my timeline. I'm like, what is going on? So I did some research, and mind you, my gynecologist talked about this maybe last year. She was like, you're going into your perimenopausal phase, so we need to get you prepared for like menopause and things like that. We need to check your iron, make sure you know things are good there. We need to check your vaginal health. Have you experienced any vaginal dryness before sex and stuff like that? I'm like, what are you talking about? No, I haven't experienced any of that. But as soon as I turn 40, here comes the vaginal dryness. I'm like, it used to be a waterfall. What's going on here? So one of the ladies on TikTok says she has a lot of like night sweats and hot flashes. And I'm like, that explains so much. Because when I tell you, I get so hot, I'm sweating, I'm like, I have to have one leg out of the cover. And I'm a person that likes to be hot and cold at the same time. So my feet, I like to have some type of heat on my feet. And then everything else, I like to be cold. But I get so hot and going through night sweats, it's crazy. And I'm like, what is going on? Like I said, vaginal dryness. I'm like, you know, my husband and I have to really do foreplay in order to, you know, get some things going. But I'm like, what? Like, it's crazy how one day on January 30th at 39, I was fine. And then January 31st, as soon as I turned 40, that day, my body wants to be like, okay, now we need to start preparing. So exploring some tips or resources in regards to vaginal health, life in your 40s, perimenopausal, I would say just prepare. There's going to be some things. I mean, you can also prepare with maintaining your healthy weight, you know, maintaining your diet and everything like that. But I will say this, it has been hard because sometimes the taste of food, I don't want it. And that's one of the symptoms of perimenopausal. So let's go down the list of the symptoms of being a perimenopausal woman. I have been a victim per se, of the menstrual changes. Sometime my cycle will be light. It'll last 3 days and then it's over. Sometimes it'll be longer. It'll last like 2 weeks and I'm like, what in the world is going on? And that comes with menstrual changes during perimenopausal. Yeah, so that's one of the symptoms, like I said before, the hot flashes, the night sweats, and mood swings. Now, I do get mood swings, and normally I'm just like, I'm a free, go with the flow. I'm an Aquarius. We go with the wind. We're going with the wind fabulous, you know what I'm saying? But I have become more irritable a little bit, and I'm just like, I'm trying to check myself because I know it's not normally me. And I noticed I get peopled out really. I already got peopled out. I'm a person that don't like people. But I'm getting even more peopled out. I really don't want to be around anybody but like maybe close friends, close family, and my husband. That's it. And like I talked about before, vaginal dryness. Now, this can cause discomfort during sex. And I will tell you this, keep lube, like an aloe-based or water-based lube nearby if you need to for, you know, sexually active women in their 40s. Keep something by to, you know, get you going. You know what I'm saying? And other symptoms include urinary urgency. I've had that. I've had sleep problems where I can't sleep. I remember the night before a project was due for my job, I literally got an hour of sleep. I could not sleep. I put the phone away maybe like an hour or two before. Nothing. I could not sleep for anything. I literally had an hour of sleep. And it's crazy. Like digestive problems. I've had major gas. My husband will tell you that I've had major gas. So much bloating in my stomach. I've had itchy skin. I've had rashes, redness. I've constantly had congestion from allergies. That's another symptom. Skin conditions like eczema and rosacea can worsen. I've had venous eczema on my feet, where I've been putting like cream just to make sure it doesn't like flake and scale and look crazy. I've also had the irregular heartbeat where it'll skip a beat sometimes, or chest pain, shortness of breath. It's been crazy, you all. Crazy. And some other symptoms include difficulty concentrating, which is forgetfulness, attention issues, and memory loss. I've had to where I will forget or I can't concentrate on what someone is talking about. Now, I already couldn't concentrate because I have like 50 to 100 tabs open at one time in my brain at any given time. But it's gotten worse. And I'm just like, oh, no, what is going on? I used to have a sharp mind. I have to do like these little challenges and stuff on these apps to keep my mind sharp. Some other symptoms include breast tenderness, headaches, weight gain, bloating, joint pain, muscle tension, decreased muscle strength and mass, dizziness, changes in taste, burning mouth sensation, body odor, hair loss, brittle nails, tinnitus, bleeding, gums, tingling extremities, and electric shocks. Like, I've experienced everything but the burning mouth sensation. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I have to get back to it, do my holistic remedies. And I usually have a bottle or take a drop or two of, or 1 milliliter drop of the Adrenal and Focus from Mary Ruth's. It's like an all natural focus supplement. And I usually take iron pills now, and I've never been the one to take iron pills. Oh my gosh, it's crazy. But let me know in the comments if you like experienced any of these, or if you're a woman that's going through perimenopausal or perimenopause at this time. You can be, I know someone who started in their early 30s. Mind you, I don't have kids. I have two bonus babies that I love with all of my heart, and I have nieces and nephews who I love with all of my heart. I have been pregnant once, but that resulted in a miscarriage. So, but I haven't had any blessings before then. So let me know in the comment section, like, have you all been experiencing this, and how are you feeling? How are you dealing? How do you combat certain things? Let me know in the comments. I appreciate you all for listening, because it's been a struggle. And listen, oh my gosh, but this is the final look. Let me know what you all think. I appreciate you so much for listening. And with that being said, it's your girl Letty, and I'm out. Peace.